Good morning, Saylorville. I am Mike Nemmers. I am related to Pat in a distant manner. I stand before you as a born-again Christian.
Amen.
I was born into a good family, Catholic family. There were five children in that family. And we were raised going to church every Sunday. But around the age of 12, and I was the oldest, we had a little disaster in our family. My father passed away. And it was a tough time for me, understanding what had happened and why. And as I proceeded to grow and become a I-know-all teenager, and started running with friends, and after high school, moving on, I just kind of slowly went away from the church. And I thought that I understood what God wanted, and I tried to make my life good. So I went into the service. I wound up getting married at a young age. That marriage lasted 10 years, but it produced two lovely children, a daughter and a son. Unfortunately, as we divorced, I lost my job. I had to go get into some new training and move on to a new career. And while I was in training, this lovely lady that's standing next to me here, we met. And a couple years after that, we were married and merged our two families together. I had two children, she had one. We raised them, and they are now flew the nest and are enjoying life. They have blessed us now with three grandchildren, one on the way, and a step-grandchild. But all at that time, I still was missing the point. And in 2001, I came down with cancer. And fortunately, it was a slow progressing cancer. And through many treatments and having my wife next to me all the way, I stand before you today. And as I kind of look back on it now, I see that the Lord had plans. I had discussed things with the Lord, and I felt that I was good enough, and that if it was time for me to go, I was ready. But during work, I met a friend, and that friend is a longtime attendant here at Saylorville, John Schuster, he and his family. And John and I talked about many things, and he brought up the Bible. And as the cancer kind of took a toll on me, I went on disability. And John stuck with me. And we started going out to lunch every once a month or so. And we would talk about work, and he would also bring up the Bible and Pastor Pat Nemmers. He lured me to come to church. And last April, I broke down, and I said, yes, we will come to church. And I was amazed at the service. And I met Pat after the service. And the following Wednesday, my wife and I went over to Pat's house and met his wife, Marilyn. We sat down, I brought in a big tree. We were gonna go through our family. That was not his plan. He started asking me questions about whether I was saved or not. And to me, I said, no, I don't know if I'm saved. I think that's God's plan. I don't know. And he says, I will show you. And from that point on, we had Bible studies. And on May 3rd, I broke down in tears in his office. I prayed to the Lord, let him know that I am a sinner and that I have accepted him full-heartedly as my Savior.
Amen.
And from
thank you.
And from that point on, my life has just been absolutely wonderful. I'm calm, I feel at ease, and what I have found out that my daughter and her family and many people in her group had prayed for me. And I just found out that everything was good. And I'm here. And I appreciate the Lord for that.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Let's hear from his wife, Anita. Anita?
Well, our story is actually tied together. And I will tell you that I was also raised in a very large, loving Catholic family. And we went to church every Sunday. I went to college a couple years and met a man and got married, had a child, and it was a difficult marriage, and I left that marriage pretty distraught. Met Mike way before I was ready to meet anybody, and dated a couple years before he asked me to marry him. We went to the Catholic Church to get married, actually, and found out that we couldn't because we needed an annulment first before we would be blessed in a church wedding. It was going to cost us money, and we were living paycheck to paycheck already. So for us, it was really a hardship to do it, and it really didn't even make sense to us to do it that way. So we got married by the justice of the peace, like they suggested, and we really never went back to the church because we really didn't feel like we fit there. We weren't really getting out of that church what we felt like we needed. So we raised our kids. We really never went back. We always felt guilty for not having a church family. And we decided to just find a church, but we just never did it. So as the kids had grown, the last one went to college, and all of a sudden we were hit with the devastating news through a regular physical that Mike had cancer. So 16 years ago, we went through the hardship and the agony knowing he had cancer that was treatable but not curable, and we continued to talk about it, but we never really did anything about going back to church and finding a church family. In the meantime, and a little bit prior to that, our daughter, our oldest, married a man that was brought up in the Christian faith, and brought up as a Christian, and all those little things in our lives kind of hit from, you know, periodically. So we had David, you know, bringing Melissa into the Christianity and the kids, and people periodically through work asking me if I knew Pat Nemmers. So it was constantly, you know, coming at us in different directions. And then when John Schuster and Karen friended Mike, you know, that was kind of all put together, and then we agreed to go to the church, and it's been such a blessing since. And I will tell you, when we met with Pastor and Marilyn, I thought I was being supportive and being there for Mike, and he quickly turned it on me and asked me a question that put me on the spot. And granted, it was late. It was after 9 o'clock at night. And he asked me if I'd want to know if I was not going to heaven. And I just thought about it for a minute, and I said, no. I really didn't want to know, because in my mind I was going to heaven, and I didn't want anybody else to tell me I wasn't, because I was a good person, I explained, and I always tried to be good in everything I did. Well, he kept asking me, and through the Bible studies that we did, it took me a little bit of time to figure out that good works didn't get you anywhere. Mm-hmm. And it was more of a worldly thing, and the prayers that I was saying through the years, you know, because we did believe in Jesus Christ, were more worldly and really weren't, you know, praying to God. So on May 24th, in my kitchen, sitting there reading the Bible, preparing for the studies, it really all came together for me, and I accepted Jesus Christ as my Savior.
Amen. 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 Amen.
And I will tell you also that it's brought great peace to me.
Mm. Amen.
I know we'll be good together, and I'm not worried about Mike.
Mm. Amen. And the Bible says, being justified by faith, we do have peace with God. and through our Lord Jesus Christ. And it's been a joy. We continue to work with the two of you. You're brand new Christians, barely a month or two old in the Lord. And it's been a joy to watch the two of you progress in your walk with Jesus as well. Let's pray for Mike and Anita, shall we? Father, thank you so much for Mike and Anita Nemmers. Thank you for all of these providential circumstances that you brought together, including bringing a man from this very church to love on Mike enough to tell him about Christ and bring him here to church to introduce him to us. And then, Lord, you did all the work of saving. That saving work is all of you. It's your words, your spirit working together. And you brought both Mike and Anita to faith in Jesus. We are so grateful for their salvation. We know that Mike is still battling the cancer thing, but he has peace of knowing where he'll spend the rest of eternity. And we're glad for that. We ask you to bless both of them, give them much grace, and encourage them with this step of obedience. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Mike, we'll go with you first right here. Okay, Mike Nemmers, it just gives me a thrill to say Mike Nemmers, baptized Mike Nemmers, anyway. Upon your profession of faith and in obedience to God's word, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Good. I got a lot of float in me.
Good job, good job. And Anita, upon your profession of faith and obedience to God's word, I baptize you as well. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. There you go. Praise the Lord, dear.